buy it. Oh, they pass point by it, okay.
Not on this road, not like this.
Yep. Oh, here we go. That's nice of them.
Oh, yeah. I'm glad you knew the signals.
How did it feel for you?
Not bad. A little less confidence because I wasn't able to see some of the turns, but that was about it.
Okay, but yeah, did you feel like when the tires gave you the audio feedback, was it at the limit?
Basically.
Okay.
But it's all controllable because I think these kind of just give way pretty early. Even though they're 280 treadwear summers from Pirelli P0, they tend to slide a lot.
Ah.
Which is actually pretty nice because this car really rewards you for going slightly sideways.
It does, yeah. I noticed like you can rotate but still get out of power without it like scrubbing so much speed.
Yeah, so I don't know if you noticed I caught air a couple times.
I did notice like the crazy bumps. I didn't know if it was true air or if it was like...
We definitely lifted.
Yes.
Not in the air probably, but we probably just had that weightless feeling for going up and down really quickly. But in that moment where you're losing weight and you're coming back down, you can kind of rotate the car quite well, which is really fun. I think that's the fun thing about front wheel drive. If you catch air, you can really, really hit something really hard if you really wanted to.
Oh yeah.
Unlike all wheel drive, which I think will kind of just like shoot you in the direction so you might kill yourself.
Just eat things, yeah.
Yeah, basically. And then rear wheel drive, I think you just spin out if you catch air and keep powering.
I remember. If you straighten out correctly, you can manage it. But yeah, you don't want it to be like totally spinning. Because upon landing, it's not bad because you have so much normal force.
That's true.
That it like regains traction, but of course, throttle modulation no matter what. Cool. Thank you for that.